Okay, here we are on part four with our spreadsheet, and we're gonna go in and we're gonna use some of our numbers here and change numbers and verify that these formulas actually recalculate. That's sort of the power in these formulas. So I'm gonna first start off by making bold everything that is a formula so I don't accidentally change my formulas, because if I go in there and just type a number in, it's not gonna work. And the sheet is gonna have me go in and give Joe extra credit on lesson one. So instead of 10 points, he now has 12 points. So if I enter that in and press enter, I can see his percentage changed here, and that should have affected the overall average as well. Bobby was caught cheating on lesson three. So I'm going to find Bobby in lesson three, and I'm going to give him a zero instead. See how that affects things. Test one had a bad question on it. So instead of being worth 35 points, it's now worth 34 points. And you can see how that affects everybody's overall grade, and that happens all the time. Julie redid lesson three and now has 8 points. So we're going to find lesson three, and instead of 4 points, she has 8 points. And it's going to say that Sarah retook test one and now has 30 points instead of 20, which is a much better score. You can see that raised her all the way up, 30 points, not 40 points, from her former grade up to a 90%. And then Jen did extra credit for lesson one and now has 10 points instead of her 8, and that raised her overall grade as well. Now, the next step with this, now that we've got all these things typed in, is we want to create a couple of graphs and charts. To create graphs and charts within Google Sheets, you first need to click and select from the top left down to the bottom right the data you want to include. So I'm going to click on Bobby's name, drag down to the bottom score here for Sarah. So I've got their names as well as their numbers. And I'm going to insert a chart. Now, when I insert a chart, gives me a bunch of different options here. It first starts off with some recommendations. Usually it does a pretty good job of recommendations, and I want to choose actually this first one. Now, if the recommendations don't look correct, you can go to chart types and scroll through all the different types of charts. I happen to like the column chart that I originally recommended here, and I can go in and insert that into my spreadsheet. Now I can also go into my customizations here and add a title. I know this is lesson one scores. I can decide where I want my legend to go, and I can change the background, work with some different scores here or titles. So I can add some scores to, or titles to the left side or on the bottom. And I can even change the color if I really want to. And then once I have it looking correct, I'm going to go ahead and insert that in, pick it up, move it over here to the right so I don't have that covering up. And what I'd like you to do for this assignment is to insert a couple of different charts, and then underneath that chart, tell me some summaries of what that chart is telling me. To insert additional charts, I could highlight all of Bobby's scores here. I wouldn't include his total, but I'd highlight all of his scores, and it would show kind of a comparison of Bobby's scores. I could also highlight their names, hold down control, and maybe highlight test one scores. So I skip over these ones in the middle and insert a new chart that would show me some of that data. So again, I want three charts in here and see what we can come up with to compare some of our data. And then you can go ahead and submit this.